Hey there, and welcome back to the AI Coffee Break. Today we explain an intriguing new paper called Coconut, training large language models to reason in a continuous latent space, which rethinks the concept of chain of thought. For context, LLMs can produce chain of thought, or CoT for short, to break down the problem before delivering the answer. Coconut replaces words from classical chain of thought, which happens in natural language, with vectors in so-called chain of continuous thought. This lets LLMs do the CoT reasoning in an unrestricted vector space instead of being limited by the expressivity of language tokens. So let's break it down. Large language models like ChatGPT or Llama are not bad at reasoning. Normally in CoT reasoning, these models break down complex problems into step-by-step natural language explanations. They generate each reasoning step like any normal other text output, namely by taking in a sequence of tokenized text and producing the next text token. Then this output token goes back in as input to produce the next token and so on. But there's a catch. CoT operates in a so-called language space where each reasoning step is a text token and sounds logical, but it turns out that it isn't always optimal because many of these tokens are just linguistic fluff, useful for fluency but not critical for actual reasoning. And some other tokens, they're super challenging, requiring planning and know-how. The idea of the Coconut paper is to let these models think more freely without being tied to words. With chain of continuous thought, LLMs can reason in vectors instead of words. So instead of translating vectors into language at every step, the model keeps its thoughts continuous and only translates vectors into words for the answer. Think of it as a better and more direct way for models to process information. Text tokens need to commit to one meaning or multiple meanings, but this is limited to the polysemy of a word. And a chain of words does not allow for a breadth-first search exploration. But continuous vectors do, as you can superimpose a lot of information into a vector, which can encode multiple alternative next reasoning steps into a single chain of vectors. To understand how Coconut works, let's shortly recap how LLMs work normally. LLMs generate the next text token from an input text. To do so, they first output a vector, which a linear layer maps to text token probabilities. A decoding algorithm selects the next token based on these probabilities. And this text token, which we just produced, feeds back into the input text sequence to generate the next output text vector and text token from it. The process repeats until the text is complete. Now, here is how Coconut works. Instead of outputting a token after each reasoning step, Coconut uses the output vector state as the next input. It's a bit how RNNs used to work, if you remember those, but the pre-trained LLM is not prepared, so to say, to get the output vectors right back as input. The LLM would not know what to do with these vectors since it expects output vectors to unembed to text, text which is then tokenized and embedded into vectors and only then fed to the LLM. Thus, the authors train an LLM to act like Coconut expects. So they fine-tune the pre-trained GPT-2 model on datasets of CoT and answers to teach the LLM how to output and receive continuous thoughts vectors. The training works like this. Training begins with standard LLM supervised training on datasets containing CoT and answers such as GSM-8K. So the model learned to generate the text from training, including CoT reasoning and final answers. In this phase, the LLM worked normally, feeding the last generated text token back as input to produce the next text token. In the next phase of training, the model started to go to continuous CoT mode progressively, in K stages, each introducing more continuous thought steps. The first K CoT text tokens were replaced with special tokens marking continuous thoughts. These continuous thoughts were framed by start and end tokens. During this training phase, at each continuous thought step, the LLM directly fed its output vectors back as input without decoding them into text. For all the text tokens, it acted like a normal LLM depicted here on the left, first decoding the output vector into text token and feeding those back into the LLM. Important is to note that while for text output the loss penalizes the model every time it does not hit the right text token from the data, in continuous chain of thought there is no ground truth to compare to, so the loss function did not apply to the continuous thoughts but instead relied on the correctness of the final answer, encouraging the model to optimize the reasoning process indirectly, since a successful reasoning process would lead to a correct answer. After training, during inference, the LLM receives the text and will start a continuous CoT phase with producing the special token begin of thought. After that token, it works in continuous CoT mode where it directly uses its output vectors as input for reasoning, bypassing text decoding until reaching the special CoT end token. At this point, it switched back to normal mode to generate the final answer in text. The experiments in the paper are indeed interesting because for GSM8K, which contains school-level math problems, Coconut could not quite reach the accuracy of classical CoT. But importantly, Coconut used far less CoT steps than classical CoT. This is important because each token in CoT needs an entire LLM forward pass, which costs time. Also, the unembedding layer in LLMs mapping the output vectors to the vocabulary space is huge and costly because that linear layer is a matrix of size, hidden dimensionality times vocabulary size. Typical values for that are 2048 times 60,000. So not unembedding spares compute and arrives faster at the answer with Coconut. On ProntoQA, a question answering dataset featuring fictional concepts and tree structured conditions as reasoning graphs, the results were more favorable for Coconut. Well, since the benchmark is saturated with models reaching accuracies of almost 100%, we can see that vanilla CoT reached 98.8% accuracy and needed 92.5 tokens on average for CoT. Coconut reached 99.8% accuracy and needed just 9 thinking vectors on average, which is way less compute. Because ProntoQA is so saturated and not challenging enough, the authors made ProsQA, inspired by ProntoQA, but with more complex reasoning graphs. Their vanilla CoT reached only 77.5% accuracy and used 49.4 text tokens on average, while Coconut reached 97% accuracy, needing only 14.2 CoT vectors on average. Which is much better, saves a lot of time. But it's concerning to hear about Coconut compressing verbose language-based chain of thoughts into dense vectors, because this comes at the expense of interpretability, right? After all, we can understand words, but how do we make sense of arrays of numbers? But here's the good news. It turns out that for interpretability, the unembedding layer still works. The authors could map those continuous CoT vectors back into the language space to see what they represent. Interestingly, instead of producing a single word, these vectors often encode a distribution of words, like here 180 and 9. This distribution reflects a breadth-first search through reasoning paths because vectors can capture multiple potential next steps simultaneously. But this raises the interpretability question again. What does it mean when a vector represents a superposition of words? While it enables more complex reasoning, it might also make it harder to trace back the reasoning process. Unlike a clear sequence of symbolic words, these distributed representations with 2 of 180 and 19 could obscure the reasoning path, complicating our ability to understand or debug the model's thought process. That said, this interpretability might break even more as we scale the approach further. Let's not forget that the LLM begins its training in text CoT mode and gradually transitions into continuous CoT mode. As a result, the initial CoT vectors remain closely tied to the human readable language, making them easier to interpret. However, if we prioritize continuous CoT during training even more than this paper did and give the model more freedom to develop its reasoning in latent space, these vectors could drift further and further away from the language space, and over time the LLM's own vector language might become less and less aligned with the human readable words. So, to get back to the big picture, Coconut opens the door to reasoning beyond language and makes CoT faster. This could make AI better at tasks regarding planning, exploration, or handling uncertainty. And while the method is still in its early stages, as the authors trained only GPT-2 on it, it's a promising step towards more flexible and more capable AI. And I'm excited to see whether this scales to even larger LLMs. Do you think this approach is promising? Anyway, that's it for today's AI Coffee Break. So if you found this breakdown helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe for more AI Coffee Breaks.